Right, let's get started. Hello everyone, this is Kim. This is the lecture 15. This is the last lecture in this semester. So, okay, so before then, we have an announcement for the final exam. So, yeah, we already, you may already receive this email, right? So, yeah, final exam, date is June 21, from 5 p.m. to 6:30 p.m. Location is Science Library Building, 611 and 615 for an exam. So we will cover lecture 7 to the 13th, today's lecture. You're allowed to bring a one-page, one A4 size cheating sheet, both sides, similar to the midterm exam, and any electrical device are not allowed in. And please bring your student card to check your attendance, okay? Okay, so yeah, this is final exam. 노스먼, any question? 자, 중요하니까 우리 한국말로 한번 더 할게요. 우리 기말고사 공지, 6월 21일 우리 시험 마지막 날이네요, 그렇죠? 6월 21일 시험 기간 마지막 날이니까 유종 의미를 거두고 여러분 방학 가면 좋겠고요. 21일 날 화요일 날이고요. 오후 5시부터 30분까지 볼 거고요. 시간은 30분, 이거는 조금 조절할 수도 있어요. 뭐 문제 난이도에 따라서 좀 더 일찍 끝날 수는 있다. 5시에 시작할 거다. 그리고 이제는 과학도서관 611. 과동은 알죠? 저번에 여러분이 갔던 애 우정정보관인 거고, 요건 이제 과학도서관이에요. 여러분 다음 학기부터 이제 대면이니까 이거 알고 있어야 돼요. 과도관 611과 615, 6155, 그쵸? 해서 두 팀으로 나눠서 볼 거다. 범위는 렉처 노트 기준으로 7장에서 13장까지다. 뭐 알겠지만 A4 사이즈 한 장 앞뒷면으로 된 A4 사이즈로 치팅 시트 가져와도 되고요. 전자기기 불가하고 학생증 지참. 알겠죠? 퀘션. 퀘션. 노? 노 퀘션? 오케이. And today, let's finish singular vertical position part. Okay, so last week, Tuesday, we discussed the spectral theorem, right? Spectral theorem for the symmetric matrix. So on n by n symmetric matrix, A has the following properties. A has n real eigenvalues counting multiplicity, 그쵸? In characteristic equation, and the dimension of the eigenspace for the each eigenvalue lambda equals to multiplicity of the lambda as a root of characteristic equation. Eigenspaces are mutually orthogonal in the sense that eigenvectors corresponding to different eigenvalues are orthogonal. So, you get this part of the most important one. A is orthogonally diagonalizable. If matrix A is symmetric, n by n symmetric, then it should be orthogonally diagonalizable. This is a spectral theorem. Then you can represent the matrix A, symmetric matrix A, as a PDP inverse or P transpose, right? And U is the orthonormal eigenvectors, and lambda is corresponding eigenvalues of a matrix A. And this one can be least common like this one, and it's going to look like this. So this is kind of some of the n by m some matrices, so this is a spectral decomposition. Yep. And today we will see examples of spectral vector decomposition, and we will extend this spectral decomposition as a general form of this one as a singular value decomposition. Okay. Okay, so first of all, construct a spectral decomposition of the matrix A that has also gonna diagonalization. For example, okay, so matrix A is like this, 7, 2, 2, 4. This is a symmetric matrix, right? So there is the singular value decomposition, 아니죠? Spectral factorization, P, D, P inverse, or P transpose, because P is an orthogonal matrix, right? So, and each column vector of P is a U1 and U2. U1 and U2, this one, U1 transpose, and this one is U1, U2 transpose, right?
In this case, let's find out spectral decomposition. This like this, 그렇죠? How? Denote the columns of matrix P by U1 and U2. Then matrix A, our matrix A can be the A, eigenvalue, times U1 times U1 times U1 transpose, just matrix multiplication, 그렇죠? Plus 3 times U2 times UT transpose. So let's do that. Because the U1 was a 2 over scale to 5 and 1 over scale to 5, then U1 times U1 transpose is going to be, looks like this, 4 over 5, 2 over 5, 2 over 5, 1 over 5. Similarly, U2 transpose is going to be 1 over 2, negative 2 over 2, negative 2 over 2, 4 over 2. 그렇죠? Then, matrix A was 8 U1 U1 transpose, 3 U1 U1 U2 U2 transpose. So 8 times this one and 3 times this one. So it's going to be 2, 7, 2, 2, 4, which is A itself. So this one is spectral decomposition of symmetry matrix A. Symmetry matrix A. This is a spectral decomposition. Okay. Question. Oh, by the way, this one is n by n, in this case 2 by 2. This one also 2 by 2. This is spectral factorization. Right? Question. No? 질문. 자, this is a spectral decomposition. And let's move our last chapter. Chapter 7.9, singular value decomposition. Singular value decomposition. In fact, this singular value decomposition is the extension of this spectral decomposition. So, okay, let's get started. Normalization that we discussed in chapter 5.3 or the chapter 7.1 in previous chapter, diagonalization plays a part in many computer science applications. As I mentioned previously, 너무너무 많은 곳에 쓰여요. 이 diagonalization. For example, like eigen decomposition. Position. However, unfortunately, not all matrix can be factored as A is equal to P inverse with D diagonal. In other words, A, in many cases, A is not symmetric. Not symmetric. Maybe in general, N by N matrix and not symmetric. But we want to factorize similar factorization for these kinds of N by N matrix. And how can we do that? Fortunately, factorization A is equal to QDP inverse, not PDP inverse, but QDP inverse is possible for any N by N matrix. This kind of special factorization for this type is called singular value decomposition. What's called SVD. SVD. This is our last topic in this semester. Okay, let's go back to our previous lectures. We already discussed ALU factorization, right? QR factorization and eigen decomposition, right? And finally, we arrived the singular value decomposition, which is one of the most popularly used factorization. I mean, this one is the extended for the N by N matrix form by from the eigen decomposition. This is a singular value decomposition. Okay. Today, let's talk about how to do this. Let's talk about how to do this. Okay, let's suppose that matrix A is N by N matrix. It's not a symmetric matrix anymore. So this is just a general N by N matrix. But interestingly, when you compute A transpose times A, A transpose times A, then first of all, what size of A transpose times A? So what size of A transpose times A? When matrix A is N by N matrix. 자,
A가 이제 n by n의 어떤 제너럴 매트릭스인 경우에 팩토라이즈 하고 싶은 경우가 있을 거예요. 그렇죠? 자, 이런 경우에 그렇죠? n by n, right? n by matrix. And it is symmetric matrix. 그렇죠? We discussed this one in previous lectures. 그렇죠? ATA equals AT. 아, ATA equals inverse of ATA. 그렇죠? We discussed previously, right? So, ATA can be orthogonally diagonalizable, right? Orthogonally diagonalizable. Due to the previous lecture, right? Then, let's suppose that V1, V2, Vn be on also normal basis for the Rn consisting of the, 여기 오타가 있네요. Consist of eigenvectors. Eigenvectors, ATA. ATA eigenvectors 이루어진 also normal 벡터를 V라고 하고, lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda n be the associated eigenvector, eigenvalues of ATA. ATA라고 합시다. And for I, greater than equals to 1 or smaller than equals n, I에 대해서 square of AB, square of the length of the AVI is equal to AV transpose, AVI transpose times AVI, 그렇죠? Then, which is equals to VI transpose times ATA, V, 그렇죠? By the definition, right? Then, because the VI is the eigenvalues for the eigenvectors for the ATA, this one is going to be lambda I VI, lambda I VI, 그렇죠? Then, we already know V1, VI is also normal vector, so VI transpose VI should be 1, 그렇죠? Length of VI should be 1, so this one is going to be lambda i, 그렇죠? Lambda i. So in here, we'd like to introduce a concept, singular values of matrix A, square root of the eigenvalues of ATA, square root of eigenvalues of ATA, denoted by sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma n, where sigma I equals to lambda I, lambda I, lambda I. In other words, from this equation, sigma I is lambda I, this is singular values, 그렇죠? Sigma I is equal to square root of the lambda I, which is equal to length of A VI. Length of A VI. In other words, singular values are length of the vector AV1, AVN. AV1, AVN. This is just definition. This is just definition. Singular value. 그렇죠? Then, we can derive one more theorem. Suppose that V1, V2, and Vn on is on also normal basis of the Rn consisting of the eigenvectors of ATA, arranged so that corresponding eigenvalues of ATA satisfy lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda n, decreasing order, right? And suppose that matrix A, n by matrix A has R non-zero singular value. R non-zero singular value, then AV1, AV2, AVR is an orthogonal basis for the column space matrix A and length of matrix A is R. Too difficult, right? Then AV1, AV2, AVR is orthogonal basis for the column space of matrix A and length of matrix A, length of matrix A is R. First of all, let's prove this one. And let's go back to here. First of all, because the VI and lambda J VJ are orthogonal for if I is not equal to J, because they are also normal bases, right? Then AVIT, AV transpose times AVJ is equal to VI transpose times A transpose times A times VJ. Then this one is VI transpose times lambda J VJ. This one is going to be lambda J VJ by the definition. But because they also know it's going to be zero. So AVI transpose times AVJ is zero. So first of all, AVI, AV1, AV2, AVN is orthogonal set. Orthogonal set, 그렇죠? By definition, 그렇죠? And then, since the length of the vector, since the length of the vector AV1, AVN are singular value of matrix A, this is just also definition, 그렇죠? Singular value의 definition이 length of vector AV였죠? Since there are r non-zero, or non-zero singular value. There are r non-zero singular value. This is just definition, 그렇죠? 이를 가정을 했었으니까 AVI is not equal to zero if then only if I is greater than equals to one and smaller than r or equals to r. Then AVI is not equal to zero, 그렇죠? Not equal to zero. So AV1, AV2, AVR are linearly independent, 그렇죠? Linearly independent vectors, linearly independent vector. Why? Because they are coming from different eigenvalue, 그렇죠? Different eigenvalues. So they are in column space of matrix A. Column space of matrix A. 그래서 AV1, AVR이 linearly independent 하니까, 그쵸? Linearly independent 하니까 얘가 이제 column space 안에 있다. 이건 뭐 이게 왜 그러냐면, 왜 그러죠? So, column space means AX kinds of things, right? So, this one and this one is also form of A times X, 그쵸? So, this is the these vectors are column space, right? Finally, for any vector y in column space matrix A, let's say A, y is equal to ax, 그쵸? This is the definition of column space. We can write arbitrary vector x as a c1, v1, c2, v2, cn, vn, and y is equal to ax is equal to c1, a, v1, c2, a, v2, cr, a, vr, and C R plus 1 A V R plus 1 C N V C N A V N. Then what else? Yeah. Then this one is zero. This one is zero. So why? Because we only consider R non-zero singular value. So it means that there are M minus R zero singular value. So, singular values, n minus r singular values, so it should be zero. So it's going to be like this, right? So why in span of this vector, span of this vector with the coefficient c1, c2, and cr, we show that AV1, AVR is an orthogonal basis for the column space of matrix A. A. Hence, length of matrix A, length of matrix A, by the definition, 그쵸? Length of matrix A is dimension of the column space matrix A, so this is R. So, to summarize, length of matrix A is R. R. This is just proof. Please do not focus on the proof, just focus on here. Theorem itself. So in other words, if A has R non-zero singular values, right? A non-singular value, AVR is also corner basis for the column space and length of matrix A is R. Length of matrix R. Why do we have to know this theorem? We will formulate singular value decomposition by using this theorem. So we will use this theorem in singular value decomposition. So in singular value decomposition, first of all, we are considering n by n, 그쵸? We are considering arbitrary n by n matrix. So decomposition of matrix A, n by matrix A involves n by n diagonal matrix sigma of form like this, D000. This is also definition. Sigma, large sigma should be n by n, and matrix D should be R by R. This one should be R by M. 아니죠. R by M minus R. This one should be M minus R times R. This one should be M minus R times M minus R. This is just a diagonal matrix sigma where D is an R by R diagonal matrix for some R, not extending smaller of the M and N. 그렇죠? M보다, MN보다 작은 R인 경우 이런 매트릭스 있다고 가정을 하는 거고요. 이때 이제는 우리가 이거 제일 중요한 이 싱글러 밸리티 컴포지션 theorem을 이제 할 수가 있죠. 자, 싱글러 밸리티 컴포지션. 싱글러 밸리티 컴포지션. Let matrix A be an n by n matrix with rank R. Let's suppose that we have an arbitrary matrix n by n matrix. Like this. A가 n by n이고 A가 m by n이고요. 랭크가 A일 때, 그렇죠? And there exists an n by n matrix sigma, 그렇죠? 이렇게 생긴 sigma가 있을 건데, 이렇게 생긴 sigma 있을 건데, for which diagonal entries in T, 그렇죠? T are the first R singular values of matrix A, 그렇죠? 아까 얘기했던 R singular values matrix A이고, sigma 1, 그렇죠? sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma R 제로보다 큰 시그마 1으로 구성 시그마로 구성된 R singular value로 구성되어 있고 and there exists n by n orthogonal matrix U and n by n orthogonal matrix V such that A is equal to U sigma D transpose U D sigma D transpose U sigma V transpose. This is the singular value decomposition. Singular value decomposition. This is our last topic. Singular value decomposition. In other words, your arbitrary matrix A can be factorized U, whose size of n by n and matrix sigma. Matrix sigma. Which is n by and one more matrix V transpose, which is n by n and T consisting of the matrix T and 0 and 0 and matrix T at R by R. And T, this matrix T consisting of the singular value sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma r, and 0. 아, 아니죠. sigma r까지죠. sigma r. This is the singular value decomposition. This is the singular value decomposition. If arbitrary matrix n by n matrix with rank r can be factorized u sigma vt, and U is n by n orthogonal matrix, and V is n by n orthogonal matrix, and sigma consisting of T, T consisting of the singular values. This is the singular value decomposition. Question. 자, 이제 이번 학기 우리 마지막 theorem이 decomposition이 될 거예요. 그래서 자, 우리가 아까 말했지만 orthogonal diagonalizable 하거나 또는 diagonalizable 하면 사실 호흡하는 곳에 쓸수 있고 너무 좋은데 여러분들이 가지고 있는 대부분의 매트릭스는 n by n일 수도 없고 대부분의 n by m 매트릭스이면서 n by m 매트릭스면서 시메트릭하지도 않은 경우일 거예요. 저 이런 경우에도 fortunately하게 그 아이겐벡 디컴포지션과 유사한 싱귤러벨 디컴포지션하게 존재하고 U, 시그마, V 트랜스포즈로 표현될 수 있다 라고 하는 게 바로 싱귤러 밸류 디컴포지션이라는 겁니다. 그렇죠? Question. So far. 자, 정확히 질문은 NCAR이면 모든 시그마는 0보다 커야 하지 않나요? 아니면 그런 조건은 없어도 되나요? 자, 너무 좋은 질문이고요. 여기 말하는 거 시그마. 시그마는 0보다 크거나 같다는 조건이 붙죠. 그렇죠? 자, 됐나요? 답변? So, question. 질문. No? Okay, so first of all, let's talk about how to find out U and how to find out matrix sigma and how to find out matrix T, matrix V. 그렇죠? Then we can do spec singular vertical position. Singular vertical position, right? In other words, any factorization U is equal to A is equal to U sigma VT with U, V, orthogonal, sigma as in 3. 그쵸? 뭐예요? 이게 그냥 3이에요. 이렇게 생긴 거. 이렇게 했다고 쳤을 때 the positive diagonal entry in T 그쵸? is called singular value decomposition or just called SVD of matrix A. SVD of matrix A. In this case, the columns of matrix U in such decomposition are called left singular vectors of matrix A. These vectors are called left singular vectors of matrix A. And this one, columns of V. Columns of V are called right singular values of matrix A. 자, because this is a V transpose, columns of matrix V is going to be looks like this, 그쵸? It's going to be right singular vectors, right singular vectors of matrix A, matrix A. In this case, this is the singular value decomposition. 그래서 left singular vectors and right singular vectors라고 한다. That's the definition. 그렇죠. First of all, let's prove the existence of this decomposition. 그렇죠? Existence of decomposition. 아, 동인 학생 질문. 자, 아이겐 벡터. 아이겐 벡터는 음수일 수 있죠. 그렇죠? 그렇죠? 맞죠? 우리가 싱귤러 밸류는 우리가 양수라고 가정을 했고요. 그쵸? 아, 밸류. 자, 맞아요. 좋은 질문이고 여기서는 우리가 양수인 아이겐 그냥 싱귤러 밸류는 양수라고 가정을 해요. 그냥. 네. 그게 이제 나중에 이제 어떤 편의성을 위해서 그런데 우리가 그냥 양수라고 가정을 하고 진행을 하죠. 프로스마이스가 나올 수 있으니까. 왜냐? 아까 이 스퀘어루트 할 때 프로스마이스가 나올 수가 있으니까 어디였더라? 요거. 요거에서 그냥 양수라고 가정을 해버리는 거예요. 알겠죠? 좋은 질문이네요. 예. First of all, let's prove that lambda I, VI, P as in above theorem. 그쵸? Which theorem? Which theorem? This theorem. 그쵸? V와 요 lambda가 이제 ATA의 아이겐밸류, 아이겐벡터스라고 표현을 지금 했으면, 그렇죠? So that AV1, AV2, AVRA also normal, also gonna based for the constant matrix A였죠? 그렇죠? In previous theorem, then let's use this one. Let's use this one. First of all, let's normalize each AVI, each AVI, 그렇죠? To obtain also normal basis. 그렇죠? This is just also corner basis. So we want to achieve the also normal basis. So we want to put U1, U2, and UR where UJ is equal to AVI over length of the AVI. Length of the AVI. By the definition, length of the AVI was sigma I. So UI is going to be the 1 over sigma I times AVI. 그렇죠? AVI. Then AVI, AVI equals to sigma I UI, 그쵸? From this equation, 그쵸? When I is between 1 and R, 1 and R. Let's say this is equation 4, 그쵸? Now, it's turn U1, U2, and UR. This also a basis to the also a basis U1, U2, and UM, UM of RM space. Then let's U, matrix U consists of the U1, U2, and UM, and VE consists of the VE1, VE2, VN. Because the matrix U is M by N, M by M, matrix VE is N by N. And because R is smaller than M, here exists U1, U2, and UR here. Then, by construction, U and V are orthogonal matrix, 그렇죠? Orthogonal matrix. Also, from here, 그렇죠? Each definition부터, AV1, A times V, 그렇죠? A times V. Where V is like this, it's going to be AV1, AV2, AVR, and the main part of zero because the we just assume that where's that? Yeah, AV here, AVR plus one is equal to zero. 그쵸? We just assume because we only have the R. Non-zero singular value and remaining singular value is zero, so it's going to be zero. So AV looks like this. And because by definition here, AV1 is going to be a sigma 1 U1, AVR is going to be sigma R U R, and it's going to be zero. 그렇죠? 여기까지 됐죠? 여기까지 됐죠? And then let T be the diagonal matrix with the diagonal entry sigma 1, sigma r, and let sigma as seen 3 above, 그쵸? D라고 생겼던 포물이라고 생각하면, sigma is going to be D, 0, 0, D is going to be R by R. So, right? Then, matrix U times sigma. Matrix U was like this, 그쵸? Matrix U times sigma is going to U times sigma. So then it's going to be the sigma 1 u1 sigma r ur and remain part of 0. 그렇죠? Remain part of 0. So this one, this matrix is exactly same to the AV from here. 그렇죠? AV, right? And one more thing is the V, matrix V is orthogonal matrix. 그렇죠? Orthogonal matrix. What is that? Orthogonal matrix. U inverse is equals to U transpose. Then, from U sigma equals to AV, U sigma A transpose, a pre transpose is equal to A. In other words, A is equal to U sigma V transpose. This is the SVD or singular value decomposition. Value decomposition. Okay. So this is the definition of the singular value decomposition. Okay. Let me first show the example, and you can easily understand what singular value decomposition is. So here's the example. Let's construct
singular vertex composition or SVD or arbitrary matrix A, 2x3 matrix, 4, 8, 11, 7, 13, negative 2. 그렇죠? The question is, what is U sigma V transpose? 그렇죠? So, first of all, what is the size of the U? Where A is 2x3, 그렇죠? And what is the size of the U in this case? 자, 요걸 찾는 게 이제 우리 SVD를 하는 거라고 했죠. 자, SVD, U가 어떻게 되죠? What is the size of the U? 2x2, 그렇죠? And what is the size of V transpose? 3x3, 그렇죠? Size of sigma is going to be 2x3. Then, let's find out this. So, to find out this, okay, so in definition, we have to know singular values, 그쵸? Singular value, sigma, and V, 그쵸? Corresponding, again. So, to derive this one, we have to know lambda I, VI, for as a corresponding eigenvalues and eigenvectors of ATA, then we can formulate sigma and U, then you can make a U sigma pre-transpose, right? Okay, let's do that. So first of all, find also conal diagonalization of ATA to find out lambda and V. Right? So that is find eigenvalues of ATA. 그쵸? We already discussed how to orthogonally diagonalize in case matrix A is the symmetric matrix, right? Okay, let's do that. Find eigenvalues of ATA and corresponding orthonormal set of the eigenvectors. So first of all, let's find out ATA, 그쵸? Where A is like this, AT is like this. So ATA, it's going to be 3x3 matrix, 그쵸? 3x3 matrix. And this one, it's going to be multiplication by first column, first row times first column, blah, blah, blah. So you achieve the ATA. And you can easily find the eigenvalues, eigenvectors for this ATA matrix. This new matrix, let's say this is A prime. Eigenvalues of A prime, lambda is equal to 360, lambda 2 is 90, lambda 3 is 0. I mentioned to you, we will give you eigenvalues of arbitrary matrix because this is out of scope of this semester. So anyway, let's suppose that we already know eigenvalues of ATA. 이걸 이제 알아야 되면 이제 이걸 계산을 우리가 그때 했던 것처럼 to compute this, we have to compute determinant of ATA lambda I is equal to 0. 근데 여기를 풀면 이게 되는 거였는데 사실 이거는 손으로 푸는 일은 없어요. 거의 계산기로 푸는 거고 우리가 이제 determinant 이만큼 넘어갔으니까 이건 그냥 이따가 가져갑시다. And corresponding unique eigenvectors are also easily found. How? ATA A times x is equal to lambda x라는 게 있을 때 ATA의 lambda i의 x is equal to 0의 솔루션. 솔루션 is going to be when lambda is equal to 360 V1 it's going to be looks like this. Because it's a unit, so this is the length of the one, length of this matrix 1. Because we want to make also normal basis, 그렇죠? Then corresponding lambda is equal to 2, it's going to the V2, and corresponding lambda is 3 equal to V3. You can do that, right? You can just do that, right? And we achieve, and we found lambda I and VI, right? Then next step is set the vector V and sigma. Okay, first of all, how to set the sigma large sigma orange eigenvalues of ATA in decreasing order. And eigenvalues are already listed in decreasing order. 그쵸? 이렇게 돼 있었죠? 이걸 그냥 놓으면 되고. D는. 그 다음에 corresponding unique eigenvectors V1, V2, V3 are right singular vectors of matrix A. 그래서 우리가 벌써 V에 V1, V2, V3는 그쵸? 이거 V1, V2, V3는 이미 골라놨으니까 찾아놨으니까 이렇게 되거다. 그렇죠? And square root of eigenvalues. Well, singular value, 그쵸? So we, sigma 1 is going to be 6 times square root of 10. Sigma 2 is 3 times square root of 10. Sigma 3 is equal to 0. 그쵸? By definition, our sigma 2 by 3 matrix sigma is going to be consistent of T and 0 vector, where T is like singular value. 되어 있는 거. So, sigma matrix is going to be like that. 그렇죠? So, from the singular vector composition, U sigma V transpose, we already discussed, we already found V and sigma, 그렇죠? The remaining things, this U. 그렇죠? This U. The last step is construct U. Construct U. How? We'll talk about how to find out U. How? So, from here. So, from here. U, 여기. U is going to be the 1 over sigma I times AVI. So, by the definition, your matrix U when matrix A has the length R, the first R columns of matrix U are normalized vector obtained from AV1, AVR, AV2, AVR, as we discussed, 그쵸? And here, U1 is going to be 1 over sigma 1 times AV1. So, AV1, 그쵸? Length of the AV1 was 6 negative 6 square root of 10 times AV1 is going to be the 18, 6. So U1 is going to look like this. U2 is like this. So this is just computation. Ui equal 1 over sigma I times AVI. You can find this. Note that U1 and U2 is already basis for the R2. 그렇죠? We already discussed this one. So no additional vectors are needed for U and U, U1, U2. Thus, singular value decomposition of matrix A, our matrix A is going to be U, sigma, and V transpose. V transpose. Okay. 2 by 3 matrix can be factorized as a 2 by 2 orthonormal matrix and 2 by 3 diagonal matrix and 3 by 3 also normal basis. This is the SVD. This is SVD. Maybe it will be hard to understand most of the concept, but please try to understand how to decompose SVD. 그쵸? SVD and its meaning. 그쵸? 한국말을 다시 한번 설명하면, 결국 이제 arbitrary matrix A에 대해서 우리가 factorize 하고 싶을 때 이제 SVD라는 걸 쓸 건데, 어떻게 하면 되냐면, U, sigma, V transpose로 바뀌길 바라는 거야. 그쵸? 근데 이 sigma와 V는 알고 보니까 그냥 ATA, 라고 하는 시메트릭 매트를 억지로 만들어서 걔를 올소건에 다이고널라이저블 하면 다이고널라이저 하면 시그마와 V가 나와서 바로 V 매트릭스 V와 또 뭐 싱귤러 밸류니까 시그마에 루트 씌우면 되니까 이렇게 바로 찾을 수가 있는데 이제 마지막 매트릭스 U의 벡터들은 우리가 이제 definition 내에서 U는 1 over sigma times AVI라고 하는 것 때문에 이렇게 찾는다. 그러면은 우리는 이제 바로 이렇게 되고 U, V가 올소고날하면서 이 시그마가 다이고날 매트릭스를 가지는 폼으로 아름다운 폼으로 바꿀 수가 있다. 너무 많은 곳에서 이제 이런 것들이 쓰이게 될 거다. 라는 거죠. This is the SVD. This is SVD.
Question. Question. 패션. 없죠? If not, I'd like to give you one more example. One more example. Find SVD or matrix A consisting of the like this. 3 by 2 case. 그렇죠? So, in this case, we want to find out U, sigma, V transpose, right? And in this case, what is the size of the U? So what is the size of the U? Maybe sigma, size of sigma should be 3 by 2, 그렇죠? So the size of U should be 3 by 3. And size of V should be 2 by 2. Let's do that. Let's do that. 자, 풀어보고 이제 마지막 example이 될 건데 Portable Compute ATA, 그쵸? This is symmetric matrix. 9, negative 9, negative 9, 9, 그쵸? So, this is 2 by 2 case. You can find the determinant, 그쵸? Because we already talked about how to find the determinant of 2 by 2, 그쵸? 이건 이용 할 수 있겠다, 우리가, 그쵸? 2 by 2 of ATA minus lambda I should be 0. Then, determinant of 9, negative 9, 9, negative 9, 9 minus lambda is equal to 0. Then this one, 9 minus lambda, AD minus BC죠? Minus 81, 그렇죠? If we factorize and solve this problem, we can find out eigenvalues as 18 and 0. 18 and 0, 그렇죠? 18 and 0. Then, in this case, you can easily find the corresponding eigenvectors. How? By finding the solution for the ATA x equals to lambda I. So then, corresponding V1 is going to be looks like this, V2 is like this. So, first of all, these unit vectors from columns of V should be V is equal to V1, V2, V1, V2. So, and singular value. Sigma 1 and sigma 2, it's going to be a square root of 18 over 0. So 3 square root of 2 and sigma 2 is 0. So we found sigma and V. It's very easy, right? Then finally, how to find the U? How to find out U? So anyway, first of all, sigma, our 3 by 2 sigma matrix should be D. 이렇게 되는 거죠. 그렇죠? 그렇죠? Because only non-zero vectors are 1, so R is equal to 1. So this is the R 1 by 1 vector. So this is a scalar value and 0. Then one more thing is that we have to find out U. 그렇죠? We have to deconstruct U. 그렇죠? How? By AV1 and AV2, 그렇죠? How? Because AV1, you can easily find the AV1 and your AV2, 그렇죠? 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 AV1, AV2. But, okay. So first of all, from AV1, you can find the U1 is equal to like this vector. Like this vector. And, okay, let's go back to matrix U. Matrix U consisting of U1, U2, and U3. Okay, we found U1, right? But what about U2 and U3? What about U2 and U3?
Because we do not have a V2 or a V3.
We can't find out U1, U2 and U3. U2 and U3.
So in other words, other colors of matrix U,
U2 or U3 are found by extending the set of the U1 to orthonormal basis for the R3. Because the U should be orthogonal matrix. So we have to, in this case, we have to extend the set U1 to the orthonormal basis. So in other words, we have to find out two more vectors that make orthonormal basis for the R3.
How? So first of all, each vector must satisfy U1 times X is equal to 0. So in other words, U1 transpose times U2 should be 0, and U1 transpose times U3 should be 0, because this is the definition. So it's going to be the solution of the U1 transpose times X is equal to 0. Because the U1 was like this, which is equivalent to the equation of X1 minus 2X2 plus 2X3 is equal to 0. So question is, let's find a solution for this homogeneous system.
You can do that, right?
How? You already know the solution of this one. X1, X2, and X3 can be the X2 times 2, 1, 0 plus X3 times negative 2, 0, 1.
Basis for the solution set of this equation is going to be here and here, 2, 1, 0, and negative 2, 0, 1, 2, 0, 1. And because we want to achieve these two vectors are orthogonal each other, because the U1 and W1 is orthogonal, U1 and W2 orthogonal, and U1 and U2 are now orthogonal. So we further apply the Gram-Schmidt process to U1, W1, W2. Then we can obtain U2 and U3 from W1 and W2. We'll skip the complicating computation, which is calculation. So please try to yourself. Anyway, you can achieve the U2 and U3. Finally, U, it's going to be U1, U2, and U3. Then your matrix A can be factorized as a large matrix U, sigma, and V transpose. Please be careful. This is a V transpose, not a V itself. So V transpose. This is the singular value decomposition. Singular value decomposition. Question. No? Okay. So first of all, this one. U2 and U3 are unique or not? U2 and U3 are unique or not? So output of Gram-Schmidt process is non-unique, right? Non-unique. So this one, singular vector decomposition is non-unique. We can find out another U1 and U2 that satisfy this singular value factorization. This is SVD. In this case, sigma, large sigma contain rows and columns of zero, 그쵸? Like this, 그쵸? Then a more compact factorization A of matrix A is possible, right? What does it mean? So when you think of this, when we consider the this matrix multiplication, because this one is zero, we are only interested in this column vector and this row vector, because this term are zero, so we are
In fact, we are not interested in this part. In other words, if matrix Lenko matrix A is R, matrix R, you can partition matrix U and P as a submatrix whose first block contains R columns, matrix U as a UR, UMR, P, PR, and PMR. It means that this is going to be, because this is, in this case, Lenko matrix A is R1, so this one is UR, so U1, and remaining back some matrix is a M minus R, and this one, it's going to be VR, in this case transpose, so this one, it's going to be V M minus R transpose. So in this case, because the limit part of zero, we are interested in UR and VR, UR and VR, right? UR is M by R and VR is M by R. In other words, partition matrix multiplication show that A was UR MR minus UR MR times P T 0 0 0 VRT VNRT, right? Then you can simply represent this one as a UR T VR. UR T VR. In other words, UR was 2 over 3. T was just some 3 over scale to 2, and VR transpose was 1 over scale to 2, negative 1 over scale to 2. This is the another form of singular variety decomposition. This vectorization of matrix A called reduced singular value decomposition matrix A, RSVD, RSVD. In other words, if Lenko matrix A is R, you can compactly represent your singular value decomposition as like this. If matrix A has rank two, your matrix UR or VR, it's going to be 3/2 or 2/2, right? Then this representation will be larger, right? But if in this case, Lenko matrix A was 1, so we can compactly represent your singular value decomposition. So this is called RSVD. In this case, this RSVD is unique. This is the singular value decomposition. Let me show you examples of the singular value decomposition. I'd like to show you where singular value decomposition is used. What's that? Here. This is an image. So this is a image compression problem. Image compression problem. What is that? Okay, so if you have the image, maybe your format of the image is JPG, 그쵸? JPG is kind of the image compression technique. So for example, this is image 600 by 402. This is just matrix, right? This is just matrix. But to memorize or save this matrix, it's going to be really huge, right? Really huge. So you want to compactly represent your image. That can be used in low latent devices, right? And how can it then? So SVD can be used here. In other words, even though full length of matrix A is really huge, you can just assume this matrix has a loading, or if this matrix has the smaller length, right? So in other words, if we assume matrix A
this matrix A, let's say this matrix A, A has rank 400. You can just represent reduce as VD, 그쵸? With rank R is equal to 400. Then you can, well, this recover original images looks like this. But if you reduce the rank of the original images, the quality of the input images are degraded. But when we consider the rank, when we assume rank is equal to 100, the even though the memory of the this image lab images is 1/4, 그쵸? Because the our mass representation is smaller than original one. But quality is pretty good, even though there are some artifact, right? And if we dramatically reduce the length of these images, your images start to degrade, right? So you have to set proper length of your matrix that perfectly recovered your original image while reducing the memory of your images. 그래서 이제 뭐 한 걸 설명 더 하면 이런 거예요. 그래서 어디 쓰일 수 있는지 하나 정도 보여주고 싶었는데 이런 매트릭스 A가 이런 영상을 저장을 할 때 너무 무거워요. 그쵸? 이거 하나 저장하려면 사실 600x400의 픽셀을 저장해야 되는 거기 때문에 여러분들이 가지고 있는 JPG 또는 뭐 TIFF 같은 게 사실 압축이 된 거예요. 이미지 컴프레션이 된 건데 어떻게 하냐면은 그럼 매트릭스죠? 그 매트릭스를 스몰 매트릭스 U, D, V 로 표현해버릴 수가 있겠죠. 그렇죠? U, D, V. 왜냐? D는 훨씬 더 스파르스한 매트릭스니까 저장하기 쉽기 때문에. 그렇죠? 그리고 UR과 DR, 그러니까 Reduce SVD에서 UR과 DR에서 R을 줄여버리면 랭크가 만 1이라고 가정하면 또 랭크가 100이라고 가정하면 매트릭스 크기가 확 줄어들겠죠. 하지만 다시 그걸로 팩토라이즈를 해서 복원을 했을 때 매트릭스 A가 나오겠지만 approximated했지만 가장 정보의 손실이 적겠죠. 그렇죠? 이어 저번 시간에 질문 동안 비슷한 얘기인데 그래서 이제 SVD에서 보면 상위 몇 개의 싱귤러 밸류로만 우리가 표현을 할 거냐. 예를 들어 400개로 하면 거의 완벽하게 표현되고 뭐 100개로만 표현해도 어느 정도 완벽하게 표현되는데 20개로 표현한다 하면은 이제 복원했을 때 영상이 깨지기 시작하죠. 그렇죠? 하지만 우리가 영상을 훨씬 더 압축시킬 수 있었으니까 영상의 퀄리티를 보존하면서 가장 압축률이 좋은 그 랭크 R을 찾는 게 이제 이쪽 이미지 컴프레션 분야에서의 어떤 연구의 방향이고요. 이제 이런 곳에서 이제 SVD가 쓰일 수 있다라는 걸 좀 보여주고 싶었어요. 알겠죠? Okay, so let's go back to our lectures. It's almost done. Yeah. It's almost done. This is RSVD. RSVD. And another application is pseudo inverse. Pseudo inverse. Okay. So we talk about approximate solution of AX is equal to B, 그쵸? We discuss how to find the solution of AX equals B, 그쵸? AX equals B. Okay, so if there is no solution, we can't find out inverse of matrix A, 그쵸? So we can't find out solution of inverse of matrix A, 그쵸? So in least square solution, we discuss how to find out approximate solution in this case, right? But finally, if you have SVD, for example, matrix A as a VR, D inverse, UR inverse, then your least square solution can be very, very efficiently by your least square solution X hat. It's going to be A plus B. So A plus is the singularity composition with rank R times vector P. Then this is the
one of the way to find the least square solution very efficiently, very efficiently, because this is a VUn orthonormal and orthogonal vector, and T is the diagonal vector. Okay, so this is the application of the SVD. SVD. This is just appendix. If you are interested in, please see this part. I think the conditional number concept is out of scope in this semester. Okay, so yeah, that's it. I guess this is, this topic is pretty complicating. So, but as I mentioned previously, you can easily find out, you can easily follow the high level understanding of the SVD or eigenvector or eigen decomposition. Okay. That's it. Question. No? Okay. Then, okay, let's move to our final exam. Okay, so I already uploaded our previous final exam. I mean, the last year final exam problem sheet. When you check our previous final exam, there was a paper, there was a problem related to the least square solution. 그렇죠? Gram-Schmidt process. 그렇죠? 뭐, least square solution by, least square solution by, 뭐예요? 뭐, orthogonal projection. We also discussed orthogonal diagonalization. 그렇죠? Orthogonal diagonalization. Okay. So, 2x2 case, you can do that. 그렇죠? You can find out determinant. 그렇죠? But if matrix A is 3x3 or 4x4, we will give determinant solution. 그렇죠? Anyway, you have to do orthogonally diagonalization or SVD or reduced SVD. 그렇죠? Another problem is like this. 여기도 보면 뭐 우리 전에 했던 것처럼 이거 컬럼 이런 거 다시 알아야겠죠. 우리 서브스페이스부터 다시 중간고사 범위, 기말고사 범위니까 서브스페이스도 알아야 되고 랭크 개념 알아야 되겠죠. 그렇죠? 우리 디터미넌트 안 배웠으니까 이건 몰라도 되겠죠? 그리고 이제는 뭐 이런 거 뭐 수도 인버스, 그렇죠? QR 그람시미 프로세스 이런 거 여러분들 꼭 풀어보길 바라고요. SVD 우리 열심히 제가 오늘 마지막 시간 가르쳐줬죠? 우리 사실 오히려 지금 보면 예제보다 더 쉽죠? 문제가 여러분들 조금만 집중해서 보면 다 풀 수 있습니다. 자, 그러니까 중간고사, 기말고사 꼭 잘 공부하시길 바랄게요. 알겠죠? 자, question so far. Question so far? No? Okay. Then, okay, so it was the last lecture. So I'd like to conclude this semester. Okay. So this is a concluding remark, opening remark. So in this course, what have we done? We focused on topics including the systems of linear equation, right? And vector space. And actually, we did not discuss the full understanding of the determinant, but we just mentioned the determinant and eigenvalues and QR factorization and SVD and least square solution. It was about AX equals B and AX equals lambda F, right? Our textbook was like this, 그쵸? Linear algebra and niche application, 5 edition. And our course schedule was like this, 그쵸? And until meeting exam, we discuss the subspace and basis and dimension. And in final exam, we will also talk about subspace, basis, dimension, length, inner product, and Gram-Schmidt, QR, least square, eigenvalues, eigenvectors, and diagonalization, and SVD, and yeah, SVD. So, this is our full topics in this semester. And linear algebra part. So this is the final grading policy. So we had the 8 homework. So, okay, so today one more homework was announced. So we had the 8 homework. So yeah, it's going to be the 25%. We had the one midterm exam, which was the 30%.
We will have a final exam next 2 weeks. After 2 weeks, it's going to be the 40%, right? And your class participation or the attendance is going to be the 5%, 그렇죠? Is there any question on our final grading policy? Because this is the last lecture. So if you have a question, please let me know now. 자, 여러분 이제 아마 이제 오늘 마지막 시간일 것 같아서 이제 마지막 우리 final grading policy에 대해서 이제 얘기를 하고 있습니다. 그래서 우리 숙제 열심히 했죠, 여러분들? 25%였어요. 그래서 아마 여러분들 알겠지만 거의 텍스트북에 나와 있어서 모르겠습니다. 저희가 열심히 카피를 잡고 있는데 뭐 잘 푸셨겠죠? 25% 여러분들 받게 될 거고요. 미드텀 여러분 30%였죠? 여러분들 열심히 잘 풀어줬고요. 뭐 너무나 잘해줬고 파이널 이젠 40%일 거고요. 이제 출석 또는 클래스 파티시피션이 5%에 잡혀 있을 예정입니다. 했죠? 여러분 아마 이 강의는 영어 강의니까 because this is the English class, so your school your grade is under the absolute evaluation. Question: What are the criteria for the pass or fail? There is no strict criteria for pass or fail. It depends on your final exam score. 그렇죠? To clarify the coverage only from the week. To be too specific, lecture note 7 to lecture note 13. Okay? 미쳐? Lecture note 7 to lecture note 13. Okay? Other question? No? Okay. So, yeah. So, okay. So, I think most of you are freshmen. 그쵸? Freshman, maybe this course is your first semester, right? So I'm not sure this course is difficult or not for you, because I guess you have a different background. So for some of you, this course may be very very difficult, while other of you. This course may be not so difficult, right? But that's okay. If you tried to best, I think you can achieve the good score, or you can achieve the high level understanding what linear algebra is, right? Yeah. Thank you very much, and this semester, and thank you very much in today's lecture. And I'd like to summarize this course in Korean within 1 minute. 그쵸? 자, 여러분들 이제 오늘 여기까지가 이제 마지막 시간이었고요. 우리가 이제 쭉 week 1부터 오늘 13강까지 이제 쭉 끝냈습니다. 그쵸? 아마 이제 후반부에 조금 열심히 달렸어요. 아이겐밸류, 아이겐벡터, SVD 달렸는데 뭐 또 문제를 보면 알겠지만 사실 푸는 건 정말 쉬워요. 그쵸? 여러분도 아마 중간고, 기말고사 작년 거 풀어보면 알겠지만 너무너무 쉬워요. 그렇죠? 근데 언더스탠딩, 여러분들이 최소한 무슨 의미를 가지는 걸 하고 있는지를 언더스했으면 바랬기 때문에 제가 뭐 시어럼들까지 다 최대한 설명해 주려고 노력을 했었어요. 그래서 아마 몇몇 친구들에게는 조금 어려울 수도 있었을 것 같고요. 친구들에게는 조금 쉬웠을 수도 있었을 것 같고요. 근데 여러분 다 괜찮다. 너무너무 수고했고요. 여러분들이 아마 이제 중간고사 그리고 기말고사까지 잘 마무리하고 이 강의를 여러분들 스스로가 본인들 걸로 만들었다고 확신이 들면 아마 여러분들이 이제 컴퓨터 사이언스 디파트먼트 또는 뭐 지금 데이터 사이언스 학과의 친구들 좀 있죠? 그렇죠? 다른 학과 친구들 좀 있는 것 같은데 여러분들이 아마 가시는 길에 어디든 또 어떤 곳에서 많이 쓰일 수 있는 가장 기초적인 학문이 바로 이 리니어 알지브라라고 하는 거예요. 그리고 여러분도 알겠지만 이제 여러분들이 이제 대학원을 가고 조금 다른 학과 수업들을 듣다 보면 이 리니어 알제브라의 세계가 정말 심오해요. 그렇죠? 우리 텍스트북 여러분 알겠지만 우리는 이 큰 텍스트북에서 사실 몇 강 정도를 다뤘을 뿐이고 너무너무나 깊이 있는 내용들과 의미들을 가지고 있는 게 바로 이 리니어 알제브라라고 하는 토픽이에요. 그럴 때 여러분들이 완벽하게 이걸 다 이해하지 못한다고 해도 너무 디프레스 될 필요 없고요. 앞으로 여러분들이 많이 많이 공부해 갈 거고, 앞으로 여러분이 가지는 길에서 이제 많이 볼 거니까 그렇게 보면 좋을 것 같습니다. 알겠죠? 자, 우리 이제는 15분이 다 끝났는데 이제 마지막 1분만 더 쓸게요. 이제 여러분 이번 기회 너무 수고했고, 마지막 정강사에 대해서 이제 좀 해보려고 해요. 그래서 여러분들이랑 마지막 1분을 무슨 얘기를 할까를 좀 고민을 하다가, 아마 재수강의 친구들은 미안해요. 같은 얘기일 것 같은데, 이제 대부분 신입생 여러분들, 2학번 애들이죠? 2학번 프레시맨들일 텐데, 여러분들. 여러분들에게 이제 성공적인 대학원 생활, 대학 생활, 그쵸? 뭐, 책도 보면 성공적인 대학 생활 할수 있는 뭐, 몇 가지, 막, 여덟 가지 방법, 20가지 방법, 막 책들도 많아요. 내용들도 많고. 자, 마지막 시간에 얘기해 봅시다. 자, 여러분들이 이제 성공적인 대학 생활을 하려면, 자, 또는 성공적인 대학 생활이라고 하는 게 뭘까요? 자, 성공적인 대학 생활. 자, 물어봅시다. 제가 이름이 생각나는 친구부터 좀 물어보면, 뭐, 예담 학생, 뭐, 정웅 학생, 뭐, 현인 학생이었나? 그쵸? 서현 학생, 뭐 아무나, 정웅 학생. 자, 성공적인 여러분들의 대학 생활, 이제 남은 한 7학기 정도를 더 똑같은 걸 해야 되는데, 성공적인 대학 생활이 뭘까요, 여러분? 뭐, 아무거나 좋아요. 여러분들 생각나는 성공적인 대학 생활. 멀쩡하게 졸업하는 거. 이렇게. 멀쩡하게 졸업하겠죠. 멀쩡하게 졸업할 거고. 다른 친구. 여러분들 진짜 멋지게 대학 생활 하고 싶잖아요. 그쵸? 성공적인 대학 생활. 내 진로에 쓸만한 거 하나라도 얻어가는 거. 그쵸? 좋은 성적 받는 거. 그쵸? 맞아요. 다들 학점 잘 받는 걸. 구나. 뭐 동아리 이런 건 관심 없나? 동아리 이런 것도 있을 텐데, 그쵸? 활동도 많이 있을 거고, 인생에서 가장 행복한 기억 남기기 너무 좋죠, 그쵸? 여러분들, 저는 이제 이 리니어 알지브라 코스의 이제 마지막 렉처는 성공적인 대학 생활, 성공적인 대학 생활은 사실 없는 것 같아요, 없는 것 같아요. 성공적인 대학 생활이라고 하는 건 정해진 것도 없고요. 뭐 서현 학생이 대학 생활이 있는 거고, 평민 학생이 대학 생활이 있는 거고, 예담, 그리고 뭐 동인 학생의 대학 생활이 있는 것 같아요. 여러분들 학점이 4.5 만점을 받지 않아도 괜찮고요. 여러분들이 뭐 동아리를 막 10개씩 하지 않아도 괜찮고, 여러분들이 진로를 위해서 너무나 힘들게 달려가지 않아도 괜찮아요. 여러분들이, 여러분들의 대학 생활, 그리고 여러분들의 스토리를 만들었으면 좋겠어요. 뭐 친구가 몇백 명 생기지 않아도 좋아요. 여러분들이 꿈꿔왔던, 여러분들이 아마 불과 6개월 전에 대학 생활이라는 걸 꿈꿔왔으면서 해보고 싶었던 거, 그걸 이뤄보고 싶었던 거를 이룰 수 있다면, 그게 누구와 비교하지 않고, 저 친구는, 이번 학기 인턴을 하네. 나도 인턴을 해볼까? 저 친구 나 4점, 4.5야. 나도 이번 학기 4.5 맞아볼까? 라기보다는 여러분들이 꿈꿔왔던 대학 생활을 하고, 그리고 이제 여러분들이 앞으로 4년 후에 졸업할 때 돼서 이제 뒤를 돌아봤을 때 후회가 없었다면 그게 이제 바로 가장 성공한 대학 생활이 아닐까 싶습니다. 알겠죠? 여러분들, 뭐 제가 알려준 SVD 몰라도 좋아요. 몰라도 좋은데 오늘 제가 마지막 드리는 이 조언 또는 얘기 꼭 여러분들 기억하고 있으면 아마 여러분들이 4년 후에 졸업할 때쯤이면 웃으면서 우리 학사모를 던질 수 있지 않을까라고 확신이 듭니다. 알겠죠? 시간 좀 많이 흘렀네요. 네. 이렇게까지 우리 마무리를 하고요. 여러분들 한 학기 너무너무 고생 많이 했고요. 아마 조금 힘들었고 고생스러웠을 텐데 끝까지 잘 따라줘서 너무 고맙고요. 마지막 시험까지 잘 보고 우리 방학 열심히 보내고 웃으면서 다음 학기에 또는 그 다음 학기에 볼수 있었으면 좋겠습니다. 알겠죠? 네. 더 질문 없으면 우리는 이번 학기는 여기서 마무리하겠습니다. 여러분 너무 고생 많으셨습니다.